All right. It's 12:15, and let's get to the business at hand, the secret history of Chicago music. In Check It Out in your Chicago Reader. John Klemmer. Tell us about John Klemmer.
Yeah, John Klemmer, perhaps known in the jazz world and definitely recorded some major label albums, but I just feel like people didn't really associate him with Chicago, and maybe the public at large was not familiar with his work.
Mm-hmm.
But born in Chicago in 1946, and supposedly he was just like a crazy child prodigy. He's like writing plays and doing poetry and sculpting, and music was just one of his many, you know, artistic disciplines. But I guess he was playing guitar at age 5.
Wow.
Alto sax at 11, and then he switched. But he pretty much started gigging, you know, at age 11 as well.
Wow.
You know, so that's pretty crazy. I guess in high school he switched to tenor sax, and he pretty much got signed to Chess Records like right after graduating.
That's amazing.
You know, yeah, right after, which is just like, whoa. So, you know, they definitely predicted, you know, big things for him.
Mm-hmm.
And he basically recorded one of the, I had not even quite realized this, but perhaps the first jazz fusion album, 1969, Blowin' Gold, which I must admit I don't have, and now I'm going to be looking for. Supposedly pre-Bitches Brew, you know, and all that, he kind of was prefiguring that sound, you know, and you know, he's basically in his teens, you know, doing this. And, yeah, people say it's the first jazz fusion record.
Wow.
And he was also just, you know, he was using electronic effects on his saxophone, which I guess Eddie Harris did and a couple other guys, but he's running his sax through wah-wah pedal and weird modulation and stuff, which, you know, I'm always a fan of that stuff. But it was also, you know, pretty groundbreaking for the time. And, you know, he collaborated with Eddie Harris, who I mentioned, Harvey Mandel, who we mentioned a little while ago, and Oliver Nelson, big jazz guy he toured Africa with. And he did move out to L.A., you know, around this point, going back and forth between there and Chicago. But he played, like, every major jazz festival. I couldn't even believe it. You know, Newport, Monterey, Montreux. He played, like, everyone. You know, he was on Midnight Special, Don Kirshner's rock concerts. Always a good
show. Wow, you got to love Don Kirshner's rock concert.
Oh, man.
I used to love Don Kirshner's introductions of the band. And then, like, Paul Schaefer did a great job imitating him on Saturday Night Live.
Yeah,
those
are
very, very funny.
That's true.
Yeah.
But, and then in the early 70s, he got super into, like, John Coltrane. I have the one record I picked a cut off of Tonight Intensity. He's got, like, Song for John Coltrane, Waltz for John Coltrane. Like, he definitely was highly influenced. And he's kind of got that sort of free jazz, free-flowing kind of sound, a little bit skrunky,
mm-hmm.
You know, but still kind of with that sort of devotional vibe that the Coltrane stuff had. And then, you know, he was on Impulse, you know, which that label definitely put out a lot of that stuff. And then he just totally switched gears, went kind of like pop jazz, you know, and, you know, maybe pissed off his fans a little bit. And then by 78, totally changed again and did, like, a solo album called Cry, which is basically, like, the birth of, like, smooth jazz.
Really?
Like, the birth, you know.
Like you said, he made some of his fans mad. Did he ever go back to, I mean?
It seems like, especially when he hit this sort of, the kind of new agey smooth jazz thing, he's kind of resided there pretty closely since. I haven't heard, like, every out. He puts out a bunch of stuff on his own label.
Yeah.
While doing stuff still on major labels. And I have to admit, I haven't heard that kind of stuff. But from what I gather, he's definitely sort of taken that torch.
I bet he's lost a lot of fans then, huh? I mean,
but probably gained a whole few of them.
Yeah, that's true. Now, the thing that we're going to hear is called Last Summer's Spell.
Yeah.
And it's from that album that you mentioned, Intensity, from 1971. Now, we have two excerpts because the song, obviously, if it's freeform jazz, changes.
Yeah, he kind of starts off, you know, doing some of those electronic effects, you know, and very textural, and then he just kicks into this, like, amazing sort of hard bop sound, like, halfway through it, you know.
Okay.
Just, and definitely shows, like, where he was at, and it was kind of my favorite stuff.
All right, well, let's give it a listen. This is Steve Krakow is with us. It's The Secret History of Chicago Music. John Klemmer is who we're talking about from the album Intensity of 1971. We're going to listen to two chunks of it because it's a song that changes so drastically. So here we go. right. That's pretty interesting.
Pretty spaced out.
Yeah. Yeah, it is. All right. So let's now this is the same tune.
Same tune. Takes off.
Okay. Here we go. It's really hard to believe that this guy went on to do smooth jazz.
You know, it's funny. You look at almost all of the new age or smooth jazz guys, and they all had some roots, you know? Like,
yeah.
Chick Corea was in, like, you know, Miles' band, and, like, Keith Jarrett, his early stuff's out there. Even Gato Barbieri. Like, yeah. Early sides are really crazy, and then a lot of them just, they mellowed out or something, you know?
Wow, it's interesting. Now, he's still around.
He's still around. I believe he's got a MySpace, and he checks it pretty frequently. I guess I could have maybe tried to interview him and probe a little deeper, but, you know, he had such a long career, I could hardly contain what, you know, info I had at hand.
Yeah, and so, where is he? Is he in the city, or?
I have a feeling he's still, he's out in Los Angeles.
Out in Los Angeles. It's johnklemmer.com, by the way. He does have a website. K-L-E-M-M-E-R, johnklemmer.com. Hey, we're going to take a quick break, Steve, but we do have a phone call, okay?
All right, cool.
All right, hold on a second. Steve Krakow, plasticcrimewave.com, and chicagoreader.com. John Klemmer is what we're talking about, and we're going to take a couple of phone calls on that right after we take this break here on WGN.
It's been 1 week since you looked at me. Cocked your head to the side and said I'm angry. 5 days since you laughed at me, saying get back together, come
Nick
back.
Nick DiGilio, Chicago's WGN Radio 720.
I couldn't tell you yesterday, you'd forgiven me, but it'll still be 2 days till I say I'm sorry.
Hold it, now I'll watch the hood wink, does it make you stop, think? You'll think you're looking at Aquaman. I summon fish to the dish, although I like the shallot shrimps, I like the sushi, cause it's never touch a frying pan.
Yeah.
Like wasabi when I bust rhymes.
12:33 on WGN. And Ted's music tonight, birthday boy Ted, he brought in the Bare Naked Ladies. We are in the middle of the Secret History of Chicago music. Steve.
Yeah.
Don't give me no back talk, sucker.
All right. Let's talk to Trevor on the South Side. Hi, Trevor.
Hey, Nick. How you doing?
Good, buddy.
All right. Steve, that John Klemmer history, man, that was really good. And you were absolutely right. He did beat Miles Davis to the punch.
Yeah.
On a Bitches Brew. And he's also the king. You got to remember, this guy is the king of the Echoplex.
Oh, yeah.
He breathes it. And if you also hear him on the song Kings of Altamira on the Royal Scam,
mm-hmm.
That's him all over that. But also, for all the greatness that guy was, Steve, again, you are so right. That album, Cry, brought in that new wave crap. And that was the end of it.
Yeah.
You know?
Sad.
I mean, but other than that, that album, Blow and Gold, was really really ahead of its time. It had, you know what it also has on there? A great version of Hendrix's third Stone from the Sun.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. Awesome, man. Awesome.
Can't screw that up.
Yeah, you can't. Absolutely. All right, Trevor. Always a pleasure to hear from you, buddy.
Good to hear from you.
All right. Get on, Nick.
Take care, buddy.
All right.
Here you go, Trevor on the South Side. Yeah. All right. Well, Steve, it sounds like a pretty interesting dude. Now, are you going to try and get a hold of him, maybe? Or?
Yeah, I feel like I should drop him a line, you know?
Yeah.
But, yeah, we'll see. He's an intimidating cat.
Yeah. I would have bet. Okay, well, hold on.
Thank you.
This week's reader features a Secret History of Chicago Music with a man named John Klemmer, multi-talented guy, Renaissance man.